Another Albion rolls around. This time it's Neo. So let's cut the chit-chat and do this.
Thank you. Thank you.
So that's the orchestral content. Before we move on to the loops and design, let's talk about all this. To be honest, I wasn't expecting much from this library. I'm not fond of hype. I only care about results. So I was actually surprised at how consistent and solidly built this library is. It's actually rather refined and not overly artsy like the previous two Albion volumes are. As a matter of fact, this feels more like a continuation of where Iceni left off. It feels like the true fourth volume of the Albion series. Uist was no Albion. Tundra had a sound that was a bit too wet and detached, with the mic positions not offering much character. The mic positions here actually have their own flavour rather than being just dry, wet and wetter. Close ribbon mics give the strings the warmth that was lacking in Tundra. Each section has definition and the short notes are more usable for general work. The brass kind of has that Christmas brass sound. If you've seen the Christmas episode of the Mr. Bean Show, it sounds like that brass band. It can sound a bit bloomy in the far mics though, so I recommend using the close mics. Also, the brass here doesn't suffer the tuning problems that Tundra's brass had, so overall Neo is a superior and more usable library than Tundra in my opinion. The legatos aren't amazing, but they are good. Another area Tundra was a little weak in. I personally would have liked to see some more legato content here, like a solo brass or woodwind instrument, and some extra split sections to round things out. As it is, the legatos are fine, but they do feel a little simplified compared to Iceni and Logia's legato selection. The strength here lies in the usability of the longs and shorts and their focused chamber sound, which I think overall make the library worth the purchase, at the intro price at least. Of course, there is a bug I found where the Strings B low legato patch didn't load the samples, and one of the Brunel Loops patches doesn't know how to find its samples, so the patch won't load. This will have to be fixed. Until then, you can load up the main Strings B patch and use the low legato in that one. Those two boo-boos aside, the library doesn't suffer the spotty samples and tuning issues of Tundra, so I'd recommend this over that any day. Now let's check out the loops. Thank you. sounds like someone's a fan of Talking Heads' Remain in Light album. This is where we see Spitfire back in form, reminiscent of the Iceni volume. These loops are genuinely great and they're tastefully sparse rather than boldly dense. You get access to spread mapped versions of each element. Then you can reverse loops on the fly. Logical? Useful. This is what Uist and Tundra were missing. Good stuff. Now for the design content. Most of this stuff is pretty par for the course, but there are a fair few that stood out for me, so I'll show you those. Nice. Usable, value for money. That's what I want. Overall, Neo is what I'd consider a serious Spitfire library that has some of that earlier Spitfire quality and spark that they've arguably been lacking in recent years. It's not too watered down, it's not bloated, it's just a solid library with a focused sound. Neo is absolutely worth the intro price, so I recommend it for anyone who's curious and maybe on the fence. As far as the full price goes, this library will still give you decent value for money, but I think it's sorely missing some percussion. For this library, I think a defined low, mid, and high tom ensemble would have been perfect. Some synth percussion would have fit in really nicely, and some brushed cymbals. If Neo had just these three extra things, I think the library would be bang on at full price. As it is, the sale price is the most attractive option for this one. Okay, now onto some handy custom patches. These patches came together nicely and the variety in mic position tone helped a lot, which is one of the reasons I like this library. First up are the extra bite and air patches. For all of the articulations except legato, I've added pitch wheel bite for the strings. Which is good for accenting or pushing long notes harder, and it's also useful for the quiet string articulations that have a higher noise floor, because you can pull the pitch wheel down to cut the noise out. For woodwinds, I've added air on the pitch wheel to enhance the breathiness. And the same for the brass. I've even added it to the harmonium so you can push the intensity up and down, similar to pumping the organ. Handy in a pinch. Next are my scoring multis. These are designed to get simple fifths results, among others, and can make multiple played notes yield more complex chords. I won't show you everything, but I'll show you most of it. Thank you. And finally, I've added some combo patches for the design and orchestral elements. All of these patches and multis can be downloaded at the link in the description and will work in the Kontakt 6 player. So, enjoy. And that's that. If you like these videos and my library tweaks, consider supporting me on Patreon where you can get access to my monthly chill time videos, or buy an album at Bandcamp for dirt cheap. I'll see you next week with Studio Strings Professional. Check you later.